So right now, we're going to take a look at filing a hook to go in a marlin or game fishing lure. Now hooks, they come these days pretty sharp, but you can always get them sharper, and more importantly, you can thin the profile for better penetration, because when you are game fishing, what a lot of people don't realise, it's a great big fish, it can come down to a fraction of a millimetre, whether that barb goes in or not, that makes all the difference of catching the fish of your dreams or missing out on it. So I like a good, strong, sturdy hook. Light gauge hooks aren't much good when you pull really hard on the leader or if you want to really put some heat on a fish and get it in quickly. So these VMC hooks, this one here is a 9-barrow, which is what I use in a lot of my smaller to mid-sized marlin lures. And we're going to take a look at how I file it. Now the first thing I want to do with this lure is take the sides off of it to reduce the profile. Now I'm just using a standard bastard file, which you get from any hardware store. Get a good quality one, otherwise you're going to wear them out really fast on this stainless steel. And I'm just using flat strokes, long strokes, so I'm coming right from the back of the hook and I'm keeping my lines nice and straight. Now keeping that file flat is important because I'm not running the file down onto the point of the hook. I'm keeping it flat so there's separation between the file and the tip of the hook. And it's not until the very end that we in fact work on the tip. At the moment we're just reducing the profile of the hook for better penetration. It's important to keep the file nice and flat. Don't get it off skewing off to the sides. Now you might say, why don't you just use a bench grinder? A grinder on the bench is going to make too much heat, which is going to heat the metal up and it's going to make it brittle. There's no easy way to do this, just slow and steady. You can see there the file is cutting the metal away from the side. And it can be a good indicator of how much you've taken off. And every so often I'm just looking to see how much, and you can see the difference in the two sides of the hook there. I've taken quite a bit off of this side already. On this side here, there's still that lump or shoulder. Now that there, just that taper, is enough to slow down the penetration and stop it getting into that barb. And that's what I'm doing. I'm reducing the thickness through here. Yet I'm not losing any strength through this part of the hook, which is the holding part of the hook. Sort of satisfied I've taken enough off that side now. It's just a case of flipping it over. Being right-handed, I've sort of got to do it under my arm here. And it's just the same on the other side. Now you can see there that the sides of the hook are both taken right down and they're nice and even. I like it to be symmetrical even on both sides because you want your penetration to be even and not skewing off to one side or the other. So that's the sides taken off. I've taken them off right back to here and reduced a lot of that thickness. But when I turn the hook this way, there's still a lot of thickness this way as well. So we can still reduce that and get the integrity of a strong hard point. Now when we file this, to get a rounded, nice rounded edge, we don't roll the file over the top. We in fact start flat and roll outwards. And how I do that is you need a nice sturdy bench and I just prop it up against the bench and I'm starting again. I'm avoiding the very tip but I'm getting close. I'm going across the top and sliding up. Now you see there, what that motion is doing is it's rounding off this top side of the hook. And again, it's just taking more meat away from the hook. I'm doing it right back to the bend because it's important we reduce as much thickness as we can back past the barb, just so that barb can get in. But once that barb's in, we've reduced nothing from the strong holding part of the hook. So I'm just going to flip that over now, prop it up against the bench, and do the same on the other side. Now again, I've got that nice and even. And now I've reduced that sort of top shoulder of the hook right down. And you can see the last remaining bit that's quite meaty is the barb. Now, the barb's important, but there's probably a wee bit more than we need there. So I'm just going to reduce some thickness through the underside of the hook. And again, I'm just propping up against a sturdy bench. And I'm same filing motion, starting flat and rolling up. Now you can see there, I've now got a significantly reduced amount of hook from all profiles. And probably the most telling is when we get an unfiled hook. This is a slightly bigger one, but you'll see, even from the thickness of the gauge of the hook back here, what it started as, just how much more thin and slender that is for penetrating. You'll notice that this hook has also started off with a cutting style point. Now it's all rounded off, even on all sides, and it's conical. Now that's important because a cone being even on all sides is going to penetrate straighter and easier than flat sided edges. And we've done tests on that, and it's just basic physics. The thinner it is, the sharper it is, and the more sturdy and direct it is, the quicker it's going to go in. So the last thing that remains to be done to that hook now is just to touch up the tip. And to do that, we can use this file. I've got a slightly finer side on this, or we can go to a finer file, and I'm going on more of an angle, and that's just to make a stronger tip. And I'm being very careful to be even the whole way around. I'm just working around, just gentle strokes, probably about 10 or 15 degrees off the angle of the hook. Important to do the underside as well, because we want to be even the entire way around. So I'm sure our lenses aren't able to do it, but if you were to put that under a microscope, you're going to see that that's a conical point. And if I run it across my fingernail here, that should just carve a trench. Now that's not putting any weight on at all, and you can see it's carving a trench in my thumbnail there. So that is nice and sharp. Now when it comes down to that very point, if that was to just flick onto something, you'll notice that this hook is sliding across there. Yes, it's razor sharp. Now, because it's got a conical point for strength, we could be missing out again just on it catching on something. So how I like to finish all of my hooks is along the top, a flat stroke. Now, the reason for this is that if it goes inside a mouth, or it hits the outside of a fish, it's going to be quite likely the outside of the hook that catches. Now, this time when I go to slide it along the table, it's digging in. Look at that. You can see the difference there. I'm not pushing down any harder. It's just now, without that little conical edge, that is catching itself on the table, and that wants to pull itself in, and I can't pull that forward. Oh, there you go, it slipped a little bit there, but there you go. Look at the difference there. Just by creating that flat edge, it is now forcing that point inwards. And that there is my way of filing a hook that starts off with something like that to something slender like that, that's going to give you maximum penetration but retain maximum strength.